Everybody's crisp and prepared, Mind 101, out in the woods again, and guess what? It's friggin' cold. But I just came out here to shoot a couple videos today, so I won't be out here too long. But the last video that I did, everybody, you know, it's getting a ton of views because, I mean, that was like a really awesome giveaway prize. And I thought, you know what, I'm gonna bump this one up just a little bit because, you know, when everybody's reeling and they're like, oh my God, I can't believe I just had that awesome giveaway prize. Well, why do you surprise them and do another one? So I've got this blade here right now that you already know what the hell it is because you saw the video title. Anyway, Bark River Moro Barong. Yeah, look at that. That is a big frickin' Bark River. Now, I am not all that into barongs. Barongs aren't really my style. I like the barong handles, you know, obviously. The Moran handles and then the barong hooks, you know, like on Jess X. But, I mean, this is a bit much for my area, what I do. But it's an awesome blade. Can't deny that. So, I'm not going to beat on this thing all that much because this is going to be somebody else's. I wanted to let you just get a good close-up look at it, you know, slap it into some wood, you know, that sort of thing, and then we're going to give it to one of you guys. So everybody's happy with that, right? I mean, you get a chance to win this big-ass $300 Bark River. Yeah, seriously. So if you want to find out more about it, don't go away. So yeah, the Moro Barong. Big, bad, crazy piece of steel. Let's check out the sheath. So the sheath is pretty cool. Of course it's leather, made at Bark River. It's got four D-rings on it, so you could strap it a bunch of different ways, whatever way fits best for you. It does come with a strap, all leather strap like that, but sorry Mike, but that strap. I don't like big leather straps, so if I'm gonna strap, I gotta have something that's a little bit lighter, more flexible, a nylon strap or, you know, one of those, whatchamacallit, sorry Jacob, can't remember, Beach and Tactical slings that I use for my Jess X sheaths. That would be cool on this. This is a little bit darker because I did treat the leather, put some leather oil on it, some Obanoffs, give it a little bit more of a darker color to it. But this one has the polished black micarta handles. So this is kind of what you would consider a baseline model. This thing's right around 300 bucks. I mean, A2 steel. So you will have to take care of it. You're not gonna go leave it in a puddle overnight, which I don't know why anybody would do that, but I'm just saying, if you do have one of these, don't leave it in a puddle overnight because there will be consequences. Came nice and sharp, very pointy. Yeah, I mean, look at the size of this thing. This thing is crazy. I think Joe, did Joe do a video on this already? Feral Woodcraft? I wanna say he did. Anyway, now it's my turn to go, you know, beat on some, I was gonna say beat on some wood, but oh, that didn't really sound right, does it? Go chop on some wood with this thing, so let's go try it out. All right, so I got a glove on that I have a slightly less chance of killing myself, and I know that there's always people that are going to chime in and a barong is meant for blah, 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 blah. Well, this is a big-ass thick barong, buddy, so I'm going to chop whatever the hell I want with it. And I'm going to start with this tree that I've been chopping on for some time. Thank you. still don't have the right gloves. A little slick. So something this big, you know, I got told one time, you know, with that Bravo 3, like, you're not allowed to wrap Bark River handles. You know what? I bet Wilson wrap on this would feel really, really good, really, really secure. But I mean, this is a big hunk of seasoned, I want to say it's maple. This stuff is hard. That's why I like to chop on this specific piece right here. This ain't easy. Definitely ain't easy when it's freezing. All right, my hands are just gonna have to freeze for a minute because that's the only way that I feel safe. Problem you sometimes come into, you know, doing reviews in the winter. If I had thought about it, man, I would have wrapped it, but I wanted you to see the freaking handle. This thing, like, it's like hums after you hit something. Like some sort of orc sword. Yeah, it's definitely got a nice edge on it. Everything is really, really hard and really, really frozen out here. Come on, weather, you're just like making things really, really difficult to test things today. And my hands are starting to die. Like they're starting to wither. See, fingertips start to turn black. Frostbite setting in. Okay, maybe not. But still cold. So just to give you a little bit of an idea how big this thing is, I went ahead and just took the Beach and Tactical sling off my Jess X sheath over there and slapped it on this thing. So hangs really nice. And of course I could just go ahead, let's try it the other way. Dang it, winter. Gloves are just killing me. Go ahead and we'll just clip this into the other D-ring. See how this is going horizontally. Ends up, you know, because of the handle, you can hold it horizontally or just tilt it a little bit while you're walking. Personally, with big blades like this, I like to have it vertically like I do with the Jess X sheath. So that felt a lot better the way that was hanging this way, having it vertical. But, you know, because it got the D-rings on either side, it's gonna work whether you're left-handed, right-handed, or whichever way actually feels best to you. So that's nice. Makes it a little bit more versatile, you know, for the carry options. So it's probably a good thing I didn't plan on like beating this thing all to hell because it's a giveaway item. Because out here, you know, I have to wear freaking gloves. It does have a slick handle, which I wouldn't have any freaking problem whatsoever with a slick handle in the summer. But had I thought about that it was going to be this cold, you know, I probably would have wrapped the handle just for the extra security. But this is an awesome blade that's going to serve somebody very, very well. I mean, it's slight with a barong, but it does have this continually swept edge geometry. Very sharp. I mean, small stuff, you know, clearing. Goes through like nothing. This is not a machete at all. I mean, it's got knife thickness. Good steel, awesome handle. awesome sheath. You know, and I like big stuff, just prongs aren't really my thing. But I'm really happy that I got the opportunity to check it out and give one of these away. This would be great. You know, if it was me, if I was keeping this thing, I'd probably put it on a wall, to be perfectly honest. I'd probably put it on the wall of my office, because it just looks that freaking cool. Put that thing on, you know, a little mount, hang it up. It'd be even cooler if you had two of them, but that's like $600 decoration right there. Nah, but somebody wants to take this thing out and play with it. Somebody wants to go kill some zombies. Somebody wants to, you know, dress like Tack and go out and do all that Tack flippy stuff that he does, which I can't. If I do that with these gloves, it's either gonna go through my skull, in which case no more giveaways and no more videos, or it's gonna go flying off that way somewhere, and I don't want to do that. So I don't want to mess this thing up. I'm gonna take this home. I'm gonna clean it up. I'm gonna oil it up. Get it all packaged for one of you lucky SOBs to receive it in the mail. Unless you're like in Australia and those crooked ass customs that you have decides that they're gonna steal it. So, yeah. Oh, it's a weapon. Oh no. Oh no, can't have that. That's scary. So, probably same thing with you UK guys too. You guys can't have anything. You know, you probably, did they let you have anything more than safety scissors? You know, like what my kids have, you know, in third grade. It's annoying. But, yeah, definitely cool. Like I said, it's a bit much for me, personally, and what I carry and what I use, but this is gonna serve somebody very, 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 very well. And probably the next big Bark River that I end up doing a video on is gonna be probably the Vengeful One. But the Vengeful One is ready to go. We're just waiting on Crucible to get off their coffee break and spit out some 3V so we can actually make the freaking things. But before that happens, I will have my custom Dark Timber version. So we'll get to have a little bit of an idea of what the Vengeful One is like. But stay tuned for that. That's my next Bark River knife, 9-inch blade. It's kind of like the cousin of Jess X, but a 2-position handle instead of a 3-position handle. Doesn't look anything like Jess X though. But if you want this Bark River Moro Barong, go ahead and drop a comment in the comment section below. Tell me why it's awesome. If you're realistic and you know that you're gonna have like a 1 in probably 8,000 chance of winning, and you want to buy one of these, definitely check out DLT Trading, knives ship free. They generally carry the Bark River stuff. I'll have links to each one of those in the description box below. So, you know, and they carry all the other good stuff too. So other than that, there you go. Pretty freaking sweet. So Chris from Prepare Mind 101, thanks for watching. Be sure to click like, share, and subscribe. Links in the description box below. I'll be back with another video here soon, so see you then. Out in the woods again. I'm not happy. Whoa, deer. I almost never see deer out here. They're probably trying to get away from the frickin' cold. Anyway, as I was saying, I don't know what I was saying. Thanks, deer. You screwed me all up. Go do whatever deer do.